going to be a Puerto Rican and a Mexican. That's all. And it makes the best mofongo, mondongo, menudo, pasole in the world. We got a Mexa Rican it.
Buddy, who's the greatest Mexican fighter of all time?
Salvador Sanchez.
Ooh. But he was only 22. We don't know if he was. He was good.
Nah, he was the greatest to me. Salvador Sanchez, the greatest.
Look who we fought. Look at all the guys. Look at all
no, he was fighter of the year. I
when
know
he
that.
Beat the shit out of who was that that he beat?
The professor, no?
No, when he beat Gomez.
Yeah, Alfredo Gomez.
Not only when he beat Alfredo Gomez, but when he beat Danny Ray Lopez. Oh, what a whooping that was.
Hey, you know in that fight with Danny Little Red Lopez? In both fights, he stopped him in the 13th round in both fights.
Both fights. And that was it was a classic the way he stopped him. So, yeah. You know, I mean, all he gave us was a short time in his career, but it was greatness that we saw for just the third time.
He was the first one to beat Zuma Nelson, too. Stop him.
The professor.
Yeah, the professor.
So, buddy, what do you like about Adrian Granados?
He has the most awkward style.
That's why everybody has problems with him. They have problems when they fight him. But sometimes the judges don't give him his credit. How do you fix that?
I mean, listen, if that's what's working for him,
keep doing it.
You gotta help him enhance his offense.
By the way, what do you think of Chino Maidana coming back?
I heard about that yet.
He's losing weight. He has to lose about 100 pounds and he probably lost like 40 or 50
weight. He was eating good.
Well, 5 years off, you're going to eat good, right?
Of course, especially with the millions.
Hello,
of course.
I can answer that question.
There's a picture of you in the back. I should show people. You were skinny, buddy.
Hey, Mo.
No, I haven't either.
Hey, Mo, the track you gave his glove to yesterday?
Yeah, I have it.
Hey, if you didn't have to, would you still box? Or do you love it?
I love it. I love it. I'm a fan of boxing before being a fighter. I mean, it just happens to be the way I make my money. But no, I love boxing. I love putting on a show. And I mean, you know, if you have seen my fights, you know I'm gonna put it on no matter what. It's a good thing and a bad thing because I love putting on a show even when I don't have to.
Do you have a big following in Chicago?
Big time, big time. That's why I actually had to get out of Chicago.
So you can focus.
Yeah, so I can focus a little more. I'm just that down earth guy where you invite me out, I'm down. Like, I'm like, yeah, let's go. And then I start hitting up my people. You get your people to, then we always end up having a party. I'm like, nah, let me stop that.
Tell people where to follow you one more time.
On Twitter, El Tigre AG.
Spell it.
ELTIGREAG. Same thing on Instagram. And then Facebook, Adrian El Tigre Granados.
Why the tiger? Where did that come from?
Don Nacho Beristain, the trainer of...
the legendary, the greatest trainer in the history of Mexico.
Without a doubt. It was my honor to be with him. I got Juan Manuel Marquez ready for that fight with the Baby Bull Diaz.
That was fight of the year.
Yeah, fight of the year. He told me it was just like sparring, too. I was 19 years old, and that was after his Pacquiao fights and when he started deciding to move up. And, yeah, it was an honor. I learned.
Hey, buddy, Juan Manuel Marquez, greatest fighter in the history of Mexico.
He's up there. I got mine. I like
multi-division champion, proven.
Oh, listen, I'm not knocking him now.
Yeah, we can't. There's him. There's Chavez. There's Sal Sanchez.
Yeah, but I'm saying
is Salvador Sanchez.
No, I know, but I forgot about. But Marquez definitely amazing. What was it like to spar him? How smart is he? He's very smart.
Very smart. I was hitting him with multi combinations. I was an amateur, fresh out of the Olympic trials. I'm hitting him with 8 points combination, 7 points, and I'm thinking I got him. I don't know, it hits me with like 5 or 6 where I didn't know where they came from.
A great counter puncher. Look what he did to Pacquiao.
No, the story with that, I was chewing it like for a week. Every time I would chew, my ear would go.
Nobody else ever done that. And you fought big names and you sparred big names.
Yeah.